forensic science to students, it's very boring. You know, when I talk to the students and I say that, oh, you know, we're doing a course in forensic science, their faces fall and they don't want to do it. So we developed a course called Clues Never Lie, where they had to solve a murder. And we created a crime scene, and they had to study fingerprints, and they had to study blood spatter. So all the theory that they would learn in the classroom was actually taught through the murder scene. And it was one of our most popular courses. Drone development, here students developed a drone. Again, a lot of non-science background students took the course. Food choices and environment sustainability. Here the students developed their own kitchen garden. And the kitchen garden works right now and it supplies food to our cafeteria. So we actually use the produce from the kitchen garden to use in our cafeteria. Mattu mural. This was a course where students used clay. And there was a lot of theory around how clay comes into being and what can you, the history of clay and all of that. But students who had touched clay for the first time actually developed a very beautiful mural. So this was the course around that. And yeah, so they also developed their own kiln. Students together put together bricks and made their own kiln where they fired each of these murals. Science of making musical instruments, I've already spoken about it, how it interspersed music, science, woodwork and the fundamentals of sound together to produce a course, and they made some very, very innovative musical instruments. If you see down here, they made, this was a very unique, I'm forgetting the name right now, but this was a very unique, does somebody recognize what musical instrument is? I'm forgetting the name right now. This particular thing was a mix of a harp and a guitar. So they made very innovative musical instruments themselves. That one is a guitar but without a wire tightener. So all of these, so they have their own principles, and in fact one of the musical instruments is awaiting a patent. So that's what came out of these courses. Puppet lab, this was another very interesting course where students were asked to develop life-sized puppets. And the idea was that they learn storytelling, community, and the feeling of caring for another being through these courses. So, you know, while they were developing the puppet, they were asked to think of it as a person and they gave it a name. That person had traits and all of that. So they learned how to see the world through the perspective of someone else. Design thinking, beyond pink and blue, this was another one of a very, very popular courses where students you know, broke the mold of pink and blue. So basically the idea was that why should you have genders that are put in boxes, that girls should do this and boys should do that, and they developed some very, very interesting stuff out of this on reimagining pink and blue. Cycling in the city, we had a course on cycling in the city where students, all they had to do was cycle the whole day, and they actually developed a cycling path in the city which is you know, which is going to the municipal corporation for approval. Some other interesting courses were birds, where students learned the art of birding. They traveled across the state to study birds. Neuromarketing, this was very interesting, where students learned why a certain product or a certain brand appeals to you. What is the mechanism in your brain that helps you like a brand? The art of science and math. The world of science fiction, this was another interesting course where a literature faculty, a mechanical engineering faculty and an electronics faculty came together. They developed the course where they talked about the various ideas in science fiction and how the scientific theories work and how, when you look at it through the lens of literature, how it works. This was another interesting course where students learned the history of science through comics. So they developed their own comics and learned the history of science through that. Sociology of a bazaar, where they visit. So, you know, you learn economics, you can learn economics through the class where where your faculty takes you through a presentation, or you could do it through the sociology of a bazaar course where the faculty took the students across the old bazaars of Ahmedabad and they studied how the economics of those bazaars work. Are there any questions? Are we going to take questions in the end?
Yeah, there are. actually.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm quickly going to now talk about the positives of such a learning experiment. What happens when you learn such a, when you run such a, such an interesting experiment? First of all, it is very application oriented. It's hands on. Students use their hands. And you know, if you were to read some research, you would read that for anything that you've used your hands on, your bare hands on, you always remember that. So students experience using their own hands on developing something. So you wouldn't see a lot of technological outcomes coming out of ISP. They are mostly things that students can develop through their hands. Better engagement, of course, because you're using your student is an equal in the class. The teacher is not the know-all in the class. You treat them as an equal, you take their suggestions, you go along with the class, along with the student, so there is better engagement. Of course, everything is student-centric in this. The center of the class shifts from the teacher to the student. The student becomes important in such an experiment.